The U.S. government has objected to Hamid Abdulatebi's visa application because of his suspected participation when Iranian students seized the American embassy in 1979 and held 52 diplomats and citizens hostage for 44 days. The veteran diplomat has acknowledged that he acted as an interpreter for the militants. On Friday, President Barack Obama came under pressure not to allow Abdulatebi into the USA to take up his position at the United Nations in New York. Iran has dismissed the decision, saying it would take up the case directly with the UN.
It is necessary for me to announce to you that we are following the normal diplomatic procedures for this topic. We have carried out the necessary correspondence with the American government regarding the issuance of a visa for Iran's chosen envoy. He is an envoy with good, positive, and bright experiences in various European countries and in Australia. This diplomatic procedure is running its course from our point of view, and until we receive an official response from official channels and sources, we don't consider this course finished.
The move has raised concerns that the dispute would disrupt delicate negotiations between Iran and other world powers over its nuclear program.
They have rejected Iran's proposed envoy to the United Nations with the accusation that he was involved in the occupation of the spy den. That's interesting. This is what they call a negotiation model.
U.S. law allows the government to bar UN diplomats who are considered national security threats, but President Obama's step could open the U.S. to criticism that it's using its position as host nation to improperly exert political influence.